Hi, I'm Abygayl Aranjon Alvarez. I was 25 years old and I had one last opportunity to pass the math section of the GD. In 2001, the state of Texas was revamping their GD exam, which meant that I'd have to start over if I didn't pass the math section. It was a morning that I'll never forget. I was nervous, I was anxious as I made my way to the TJC West Campus. It was a place that I had become all too familiar with. I remember walking in and doing what I needed to do, and I went and I handed the test prompter my receipt, and she handed me some paper and some pencils and a calculator. It was probably the most gut-wrenching 2 hours of my life. I felt great, confident, but nonetheless nervous. So the following Monday, I'm calling the GD headquarters in Austin. Ring. How can I help you? Hi, my name is Abygayl, and I'd like to know if my GD exam has been generated. Has it been graded? Well, Abygayl, can you give me your social? Gave her my social, and she says, let me put you on a brief hold. We all love those brief holds. Not really. I remember she came back and said, Abygayl, your test hasn't been graded yet. Give us a couple more days. Of course, I never gave a couple more days. I was calling every day, and it actually got to the point where the receptionist in Austin knew my voice, recognized my voice. So we would go through the same process day in and day out. One day, I called, and to my surprise, I was getting a different answer. Hi, this is Abygayl. It's wanting to know if my GD exam has been graded. This time she had a different answer for me. She says, Abygayl, you failed by 1 point. I started crying. I felt defeated. I noticed that she was crying as well, which I thought, why in the world is she crying? She says, I'm so proud of you. That moment I thought, you are so cruel for congratulating me. I mean, after all, I had failed by 1 point. I said, what are you talking about? She said, Abygayl, you passed the exam by 1 point. It was a feeling that I couldn't put into words even now. The first thing I wanted to do was tell my children, let my husband know that I had passed. Let's fast forward. I started working as a lunch lady for Lindale ISD. And it was during that time that the Spanish teacher had told me that a substitute teacher position had become available. She said, you know, you're bilingual, that's a great advantage. Why don't you apply? So I did, and I'll say I was a great lunch lady, but I made an even more awesome substitute teacher. I took every assignment seriously. I enjoyed teaching. On a particular day, I had overheard that there was a teacher that was going to be out on maternity leave for 6 months, and they were looking for someone to fill that position. So I immediately went and talked to Teresa, which was the assistant to the principal. And I said, can you please consider me? I want to be considered for this long-term position. And so I left it at that. After a couple of days of not hearing back, I went back and I talked to Teresa. And I said, Teresa, you know, have you heard anything? And she says, Abygayl, we can't give you that assignment. I said, well, why not? I mean, I'm a great substitute teacher, aren't I? She said, you are. And I said, and I, you know, I have my GD. I mean, what more do you want? She said, that's the problem. You only have a GD. I said, and? She said, how do we know that you're not gonna quit on us? I said, you know what, Teresa? I wanna talk to Ms. Todd. I wanna talk to the head honcho in charge. I want to see if I can talk her into giving me this long-term assignment. So I walked into Ms. Todd's office. She looked at me and she said, I know why you're here. I said, well, Ms. Todd, you know, why can't I have this long-term position? She said, Abygayl, you don't have any college. You don't have a teaching certificate. There's no way of me being able to justify giving you that assignment. I remember walking out and just feeling awful. I went home and I gave the most epic, over-the-top performance. I'm a little diva when it comes to rejection. I told Isaiah, I said, sit down. I'm fixing to give you the performance of a lifetime. I said, can you believe Ms. Todd said that she couldn't give me the substitute position because I don't have any college? I said, I have a GED. What more could they want? Isaiah looked back at me and he said, you know, it's not a bad idea. Why don't you consider going to college? Isaiah, I already have a GED. I've had to work really hard at that. College? I don't know. What Isaiah didn't know was that I would end up turning into a career student. I can tell you all the reasons why I dropped out of school in the eighth grade. I can tell you all about being a wife and a mother, getting home from work and hitting the chemistry homework late into the night. I can tell you about all the tears I shed, all the times that I started and stopped, all the barriers that I had to overcome. Instead, let me tell you about Ms. Todd. She saw something in me that at the time I did not see in myself. The encouragement that she gave me to pursue a college degree was something that I never thought would be possible for myself. For the first time, I saw myself as an actual college graduate. I saw myself with a degree. I saw myself being able to provide for Isaiah and the children. I saw myself being able to give my husband everything he had given us up until that point of being such a great provider. We got married when he was 21 and I was 15. Neither one of us had a clue about what we were doing or what we were embarking on. All we knew was that we loved one another. 28 years later, it hasn't been rainbows and cupcakes. It's been a lot of hard work. It's been a lot of compromise, and it's been a lot of appreciation for one another. Ms. Todd took a chance on me in spite of how broken I must have looked. In spite of all the self-doubt that surrounded me, she continued to believe and continued to encourage me to pursue college. I find that I'm no longer that scared eighth grade dropout that is easily intimidated. I now walk with my head held high. I praise God for placing Ms. Todd in my path. Ms. Todd has been there when I graduated from TJC. She was there when I graduated with a Bachelor's of Science from UT Tyler. And I hope and pray that she'll be there in September when I graduate with my Master's in Public Health.
Great job, Abygayl.
Thank you.
A very moving presentation.
Thank you. I feel phenomenal. I feel just extraordinary knowing that I'm a Mexican woman trying to make a difference in my community.
Well, is there anything else that you want people to know about you?
That I definitely didn't give up. It would have been easy to give up. And there were times that I wanted to. But I'll never forget my daughter telling me, she said, Mom, if you quit, then I'll quit and I'll make sure my brothers quit as well. She said, you're a reflection of us as we are of you. So keep going and do what you have to do to succeed.
Amazing. You are an inspiration. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Abygayl Alvarez, and thank you for keeping us in the loop.
Thank you.